Hello and welcome back to the Akeo Tech channel, where business and technology go together like popcorn and the movies. My name is Louis Procopio, and today we're going to take a look at a quite unique permissioned private enterprise blockchain, one with the grand vision of being the single global ledger connecting institutions and people. It's supported by over 200 of the world's largest technology and industry organizations like Amazon Web Services, Intel, Microsoft, and an army of the world's largest banks. It's open source, open design, and open development. It's Corda. Corda, although originally released as a permission blockchain for the finance industry, has since last year opened up and expanded its use cases to just about every industry out there. This is obviously very important when the project's ultimate vision consists of all businesses running on the same global network. Before we get into the basic details of what Corda is, it's a good idea for you to have a basic understanding of what a permissioned blockchain is. So if you're a little unsure about the differences between permissioned and permissionless blockchains, then take a look at this video here and catch yourself up on that topic, because now it's time to Corda. Keeping in mind the fact that Corda aims to be the global distributed ledger, let's take a look at how they intend to make that vision a reality. These are some of Corda's end state principles. Of course, privacy. The only parties who have access to the details of a transaction are those who participate in the transaction and those who need to assure themselves of transaction provenance. This means two or more participants can transact with one another, sharing only necessary information between them and not broadcasting the transaction or its details across the entire network like a public blockchain would, like Ethereum, which is of course not a feature that enterprises and businesses want. Legal footing: deals recorded by the ledger are by contract accepted as admissible evidence and legally binding by all parties in any dispute. Corda provides assured identity. Parties will have assurance over the identity of participants in the network. Obviously, a very important feature for a global ledger where you don't know other participants. And this is made possible due to KYC requirements of all participants of the network and the core identity framework, which enables Corda to assign a single user profile, if you will, to any legal entity, whether it be an organization or an individual. It's an enterprise blockchain looking to also provide a solution for individuals. Unlike its permissioned blockchain competitors, Corda is open. Open source, participation, development, governance, and standards. Taking a look now at Corda's architecture, Corda is scalable. The network should scale to support billions of transactions daily across industries. Longevity: different versions of Corda will be able to coexist on the same network, and applications will continue to run on later versions. Interoperable: the platform is designed to allow multiple applications to coexist and interoperate on the same network. The last thing I want to look at is what Corda calls the Global Corda Network's principal components. The Global Corda Network specifies network parameters that define the consensus critical settings nodes must agree on to ensure global compatibility and stability. So consensus mechanisms are standardized plug-and-play mechanisms, like for example the Byzantine Fault Tolerance or BFT algorithm, which keeps independent development of Corda apps compatible on the global network. The Global Corda Network uses consensus pools that provide consistent, transparent, and resilient uniqueness consensus services. So basically, consensus pools are here to prevent double spending. The network enables oracles that provide information services across the network. If you don't know, oracles are a source of information, basically a bridge between smart contracts on the chain and information off the chain. An example would be an oracle providing a smart contract with temperature values in a freight container filled with refrigerated goods. Important information for not only those directly taking part in a supply chain, but also important for the health and safety of consumers. Lastly, the global Corda network facilitates fiat currencies and native digital tokens in a standard representation for seamless transfer of value. So what does this all mean? Corda allows businesses and individuals to transact privately between legally identifiable counterparties on a single network that is meant to be highly scalable and where applications developed by independent developers are interoperable due to network-wide standards. It is a lot to swallow, a lot of information, a lot of different potential blockchain solutions for your business to start its blockchain journey. It's daunting to even think about where to start. Hopefully these episodes are helping you to learn something about the possibilities that are out there. Here at Akeo, this is just part of the concept development process that we go through with our own clients. I wouldn't expect all your questions to be answered by watching a video on YouTube, so if you have any questions at all about which blockchain solutions out there might fit your business model best, then let us know. You can always get in touch with us here in the comments section or go straight to akeo.tech and contact us there. Before we wrap this up, here is your critical thinking question for this week, and I already gave the answer earlier in the episode. The Corda network is open for all entities who can run a node and legally identify themselves. Is Corda classified as a public or private distributed ledger? There it is. Feel free to start a discussion with us in the comments section. And if you know the answer, then please do share it with us. Are you interested in learning more about how blockchain is being used today and what problems businesses are solving with this technology? Then head on over to akeo.tech, where you can download your free blockchain guide ebook for business professionals. Are you enjoying the content here on the Akeo Tech channel? Subscribe, like this video, help us to spread this information to others, and we can all do our part in helping to assist global blockchain adoption. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next week when we take a look at yet another permissioned blockchain project. It's also open source. It's being developed by JP Morgan using the base code of the Ethereum blockchain at its core. It's a potential disruptor in the finance sector. It's Quora. Bye-bye. So what does this all mean?